founder and CEO of Latin Percussion's Marty Cohen. Martin, welcome to Salsa La Calle.
Well, here we are about 15 years after that memorial shot where we celebrated Tito Puente's 65th birthday here at 52 People for Progress Park on Kelly Street in the Bronx. The weather is absolutely perfect for this gathering of percussionists that I think will be second to none. The finest talent in the world, drawing from the Mecca of percussion, New York City. So it's going to be a great assemblage, a photograph that will rival that of Count Basie in Harlem.
I think it's going to be a classic poster, no doubt. Martin, if they want to go and get that poster, how can they do that?
They can beg, borrow, and steal. But they always have to come to LP, go to lpmusic.com, congahead.com, and you'll get it there. You'll have a chance to order it online from lpmusic.com.
Mira, si ustedes patato, ustedes también lo salsa en la calle.
Hey, this gentleman that I have on the left of me is Johnny Rivero, better known as Pequeño Johnny, que tocaba con la Sonora Ponceña por mucho tiempo. Johnny, welcome to Salsa en la Calle.
Oh, thank you so much, man. It's my pleasure. And I'm so happy to be here today. Today's a special day for all the percussionists of New York City. 15 years ago, we had a photo shot, which was Tito Puente's birthday. And after 15 years, we added up more musicians today. We have the old-timers like Candido. We have Mito Cardona. We have Eddie Montalvo. We have, you know, the best of the best of New York. And today, we, after 15 years, we are all together for this photo shot, which is going to be a poster for LP.
Mr. Cardona, el conguero de todos esos discos que tú has oído, especially el asalto navideño with Willy Colón y Omo Toro, gente de la huella, esa gente. Milton, welcome to Salsa en la Calle.
Thank you, Papa. And hi to everybody out there in TV land.
Vamos a hablar de lo que está pasando hoy. This is a historical thing. We have probably all the baddest percussionists in New York City today in the Bronx endorsing LP Latin products. What does that symbolize to you?
Well, to me, it's just great just to get together with half of these guys that I haven't seen in so long, you know. But no, un apujo para la música, para la percusión, because without the percussion, without the rhythm, ain't nothing happening.
Well, I got to tell you, man, I mean, all these cats out here that we're looking at amongst yourself, myself, and I mean, Eddie Montalvo, everybody's here, these are all, you know, in la farándula, as we say. You know, so we don't get to sit on the same stage with these guys all the time perform. So to have everyone here today, somewhat right. Spectacular, right?
Right. I think Marty did a great job doing this, you know. Because we can't even do this on our own, you know, to get together.
Listen, Milton, if you had some words of wisdom for kids who are out there, want to become musicians, want to become an artist, an activist, an actor, what words of wisdom do you have for them?
The first thing is, man, finish school. You know, go through your school thing, get out of school, get that diploma. That's very important. This can come later, you know. But get your diploma, do your, and stay away from the drug scene, you know. The drug scene, it's just going to hold you back, you know. And stick to school and, you know, finish your school. You know, that's very important, you know.
Yeah, I believe so also.
You know, man. Then you can deal with this craziness, you know.
Bueno, Milton, te felicito, gracias, bro.
Y gracias a todo mundo, ¿eh?
Willy Villegas, pasarse en la calle, por favor, no se vaya nadie. Regresamos de nuevo. Here on the right-hand side of me, we have the flautist, legendary Dave Valentin. Now, David, we talk about Latin percussion today, which is what the theme is all about. Obviously, as a flautist, it doesn't fall into the percussion field, but you do play percussion on stage with Gerald Bennett.
Yeah, in fact, I was a percussionist. I started when I was 5, and I played in a band, Richie Hernandez y La Dinámica, when I was 10. So I always wanted to be like Tito Puente and like all these great percussionists over here. But I wanted to meet a girl who played the flute, and that's what happened.
This guy's a comedian, no doubt. I mean, you've recorded with some of the best in the world. The last recording you and I collaborated together on was the Christmas album for, at that time, the Japanese company that came in. We did that Latin jazz stuff, which was
right.
A Christmas album that's still selling very well. Dave, today, all these percussionists that are here, you know, under one roof at one time in this park, how do you think, how would you make this possible? What do you think of all the characters that are here? I mean, we're talking about top percussions in their field. Latin percussion put this together. How great is it?
Well, I think this is a historic event. I mean, there was one picture in Harlem where they took all the jazz artists, right? And you know, I talked to Marty about this like 10 years ago, and now it's coming true. Unfortunately, some of the guys are not here, but they're going to be with us in spirit. The great percussionist of all time, Tito Puente, is the one that comes to mind. But I think it's a historic event, and we're here in the Bronx, and we're going to take a historic picture, which will live on forever for our future generations, and they can have. These are the greatest musicians of all time. I'm very proud and happy to be a part of this great occasion. And this is positive, and it reinforces our youth. And here we go.
You know, talking about the youth, just one more thing so we can get to, I want to get Candido, who's over there. The young kids today that are words of wisdom, do you have for them?
Well, they should listen to Orlando Marin. And they should listen to Machito. And they should listen to Tito Rodriguez and Tito Puente. They should listen to Tito Pancho. They should listen to all the music, anything they can get their hands on. And please don't listen to Kenny G.
Willy Villegas, por salsa en la calle. Dave Valentín, gracias mucho, ¿sabes?
Vaya.
I'm the last, I call myself Orlando Marin, the last Mambo King, because I'm the last orchestra leader of the 1950s who's still active, okay? People may not know that, you know, but it's an important fact. And hopefully we have a lot of young people coming up to replace the old masters. like Machito Puente and Rodriguez.
Ahora que está tocando la tema de la juventud, I call them the lost but not forgotten youth, because apparently if they're not listening to the old music, they're somewhat lost in what's happening with today's reality and concept of what salsa music is all about, mambo, jazz, whatever idiom you want to give it. What words of wisdom would you have for the young kids today who want to be an artist?
I would say that they should try going back to the roots of the orchestra. Should try to start recording songs and music that feature not only a good-looking young singer, but to feature the piano, the bass, to feature the trumpet and the sax, and the great soloists in Latin American music who are being ignored and not given the opportunity to be seen and heard. I would say that they should go back to the roots.
Gracias, Orlando. As you can see, they're starting to get this all together over here. Yeah. So I think we better cut it short and let's get to this photo,
and
man.
Thank you for Gracias this opportunity to talk to all the wonderful people out there. Que Dios lo bendiga a todos. Vaya.
Saludos a todo el mundo. Parte de Jorge González, Rafi Guizarri.
Ricky Sara de Panamá. Panamá. Estábamos comentando ahora que estaban los seis solares. La producción. Eddie Montalvo, Robbie Amin, Jorge González y Rafi Guizarri estábamos juntos por primera vez desde que Rubén nos votó del grupo. Desde que votó todo el mundo de los sedes solar, estábamos juntos otra vez. So, esto fue historia. Los sedes solar, reunion. Ah, míralo, míralo ahora, míralo, míralo. Votado, votado por Rubén Blay.
Let's look, Matthew. Okay.
Mira, si ustedes patatas, hubiera viendo salsa en la calle.